Somebody said, Swami, people are writing nasty things in newspapers about you. People have been speaking ill of you. Swami, we feel so bad. We know you, but those fellows, they are doing like that. Shall I reply them? Shall I write a counter article? This is Baba's piece. Please follow me. Look here, all those that praise me are of the size of a mountain. All those that criticize me are also the size of a mountain. I am in between blessing both of them. Why? Your happiness is my happiness. That is called peace. Whether you praise him or condemn him, he will never lose his calm and composure. That is peace. And he wants us to be peaceful. You see, on several occasions in Prashantaliyam, birthday celebration, Dasara celebration, Shivaratri celebration, hundreds of thousands of people gather there. Yes, 500,000, even more. Fully occupied the whole area. Our Lord comes leisurely, with a smile, talks to people nicely. Whereas you and I, if we invite 4 people for lunch, we'll have curfew in our family from the early hours of the morning, making everybody stand on their heels. Why? 4 guests are coming. But here is Baba with 4 lakhs of people. It's all right. That is peace. In spite of provocation, in spite of agitation, in spite of disturbance, turbulence, opposition, criticism, mudslinging, character assassination, if you are unruffled, undisturbed, that is called peace. That's called prashanti, what you are written. Darussalam. Darussalam. There the meaning is written there at the airport. Abode of peace. When I saw that at the airport, Swami, you will not allow me to forget you. You will not allow me to forget you, Bhagwan. Darussalam. Abode of peace. Prashanti Nilayam. Prashanti Nilayam is Darussalam. So he won't allow you to forget. That shanti, prashanti, supreme peace. Satya dharma shanti. Then we think of the prema, ethics. Prema. Well, what is this prema? Love is not seasonal. Not seasonal. Because at the time of examinations, science students love their teachers. Because practical examinations are approaching and we have to award them marks. And PhD boys, they love their guides because dissertation is getting ready. That is seasonal love. Some people love the boss and children of the boss. That is conditional love. Why? If the boss asks to get out, he will not love him. So it's not conditional love. It is not seasonal love. It is unconditional love. Unconditional, Baba, you give me what I want, or you may not give me what I want. You may give me what I expect from you. You may deny me that what I expect from you. You may look at me. You may not look at me. You may give me interview or not. You may give me a ring or not. A chain or not. I feel jealous of those to whom you talk immediately. when you did not look at me for 7 years. When you start going on distributing many gifts, you have not given me any. Love demands, whether he talks to you or not, whether you get interview or not, gift or not, desires fulfilled or not, if you still continue to love him, that is prema or love. So love is unconditional. Love is unconditional. Because I often tell everybody, you may look that Swami has extra love towards him. It may look like that. While I was the state president of Andhra Pradesh, at one time, Swami was talking to me every day. Every day. All the devotees, Prasadchandra, have considered that I am a class devotee, PhD in devotion. What was he talking to me? First day, you are a useless fellow. Second day, you are an irresponsible fellow. Third day, you are unfit to be the state president. Fourth day, you are awarding a prize to a district from your state where you have never been to. Next day, how do you give prize to that district? How do you know what is happening in other districts? Next day, why don't you raise your voice protesting in World Council that prizes should not be given in such an organization? Brunei, this much of audience is equal to 10,000 audience from East Godavari, Andhra Pradesh. To have this much of gathering in Brunei is not an ordinary thing. I cannot say 50,000 East Godavari Oscar Award. Brunei, out of question, no recognition. People will laugh at you. For these circumstances, for these conditions, what you are? More than 50,000 people there. A dollar and a rupee are not same. Dollar is dollar. So you are dollars. We are rupees, that's all. Therefore, love is unconditional. You cannot, that's what Baba heavily on me. While all others are thinking, Swami is talking to you, sir. How great. How can I tell them? Yes, I said. But I was crying inside. I know the music going on. Therefore, Swami appeared to be close to some people. But he is close to everybody. Never think that you are close. No. You are close to get a responsibility from him. To be assigned a duty to you. Not that you are close. Simple example. We have a servant maid. I go on talking to her every day. Get me a cup of coffee, hot water ready, wash the clothes. I have no time to talk to my son. That doesn't mean I love the servant maid more than my son. Well, if you say that, something fishy there. Therefore, my friends, because Swami talks to some people for assigning responsibilities, being in charge of certain institutions, and to be delegated some power, well, he may talk, but he loves everybody. Another point, it was the time of the inauguration of Satyasai University, 30 years ago. Swami was moving in that silver chariot along with Chief Justice of Supreme Court, Justice Chandrachud. Both of them were having a ride in the silver chariot there in Prashantalayam on the day of inauguration of Satyasai University. Now, what Swami was talking to Chief Justice of Supreme Court? Look here, Chandrachud. These are not my true devotees. My true devotees are those that are there in sheds. My true devotees are those who are staying under the tree. My true devotees are those who are exposed to sunlight, reign like that. They are my true devotees. Not these people who stay there, yeah. But we see Swami talking to Chandrachud. But he's speaking about you and me. Swami is speaking about you and me. Swami calls a president of India. What does he talk to him? He doesn't speak on politics. No. He doesn't say that you'll get next term. He's not interested. He will say, you should work for people. Welfare of the community is important. Nationality is very important. You see, education is very important. Water is very important. Food is very important. He will tell important things to important person. But we think he got interview. Yes, what about it? His duty reminded. But he speaks to those people for our benefit. He talks to those people to help all of us. That is the reality. Please believe me, having observed Swami for 40 years, whatever he may say, it is for you. Simple example. He may talk to Sinclair from Connecticut, United States of America. He may talk to Tigrade, or he may talk to Narendra Reddy from LA, US. What did he talk to them? Take care of patients properly. Build a nice hospital. The equipment should be modern. We should not charge them. Be kind to the patients. When you give injection, be kind to them. Talk to them. Engage them. That's all. Don't go like the injection. These are Swami's words. You can watch videos. Anil Kumar is not bluff master. Anil Kumar is not acting. He says on the dais to doctors, because I translated his talk. I'm the witness. So when a doctor gives injection, he says, smile and talk, inquire the family. That's all. But doctor should smile, giving a hope to the patient. That's what he talks to people. Therefore, that is love. To tell duties to people, responsibilities to people, obligations to their professions, for the benefit of others. That is love. Not calling you, giving a silver cup. Not calling inside bag of currency. Why? What do you do with that? What do you do with that? That is Swami's love. And then next one, ahimsa. Mayanjinji, I'm conscious of the time. Because I got my beloved timekeeper, whom I love very much. Then comes ahimsa, non-violence. I'm getting number of questions. Can a non-vegetarian be a devotee? Can a non-vegetarian sing a song? Thank God. Can a non-vegetarian live on earth? That question has not come to me so far. Vegetarianism or non-vegetarianism are individual habits, family traditions. Even vegetarian is not uniform. I come from a district, Andhra Pradesh, Guntur. We eat hot stuff. Chilies, 100%. And if I ask everybody, this is vegetarian, the fellows who don't eat chilies are not vegetarians, there is something wrong with you. Spicy food is relished by some, is not relished by others. We should know that. Even food is not same. Karnataka people, I met one man from Karnataka. Karnataka. They eat soft food. People are also soft. Bland diet. Bland, completely. Not spicy. When I was there in Bangalore, I used to dine in their canteen. Their Bangalore campus. Abba! Shuddha Satvik. Not merely Satvik. Shuddha! No salt, no pepper, no chili. Amma! I don't know how saints can eat that. But they like it. They like it. And if you go to Tamil Nadu, what do? Immediately they serve sambar. You have to mix all items in that sambar. Advaita Brahma. Anta Advaita, non-duality. Whereas in Andhra, how do they eat? First dal, next curry, next chutney, something like military parade. The infantry will salute and go. Next air force, salute and go. Navy, salute and go. Like that, every item will salute and go. This is this style. So, is your diet same everywhere? Vegetarians are the uniform. With what face you say, non-vegetarianism is non-spiritual. No, my boys. We should encourage vegetarianism, propagate vegetarianism, but not insist on vegetarianism. Supposing I say, my friend from Karnataka says, if you eat this Anil Kumar, you are Sai devotee, but not otherwise. How can I do that? Adella mudiyadappa. Is not that easy? Therefore, over generations, they have been taking non-vegetarian food. Over ages, suddenly it is not allowed. Who are you to say that? So, himsa, violence. What is himsa? Killing an animal? Yes, it is himsa, violence. But Baba's interpretation is different. Just wait here. Baba's interpretation of violence, himsa, is different. Please follow me. Some people looks are so violent. We don't know why that fellow is looking at me like that. What is wrong with me? What is wrong with him? Looks can be violent. Some people can hurt you by their looks. As if I make a criminal or a terrorist. So you can hurt people by your looks. You can hurt people by your words. By your words. Some people speak certain words to us which we will not forget for a lifetime. Because they are so hurting. Our thoughts are so hurting. Why should that fellow look more than what I get? Why should that fellow look better than me? Why not? Why not? In fact, lakhs of people look much, much better than you. You do not know. And you are better than millions of people. You are not aware. Therefore, violence meaning hurting people by thought, word, deed, by your looks. Swami gives example. Supposing you can eat 3 vada or 4 vada or bisi beda or madhur vada. Because I'm in front of my friend from Karnataka where I worked there. Therefore I remember these items. Is madhur vada there still now? Bisi beda. You're eating bisi beda here? Here. Where is your wife? Is she here? You're not yet married? Also, ask her to meet me. So, because they like bisi beda very much. Yeah. Yes. Some of you teach her how to make. Then he'll smile more, sing better. So the point is, in this process, I can eat 4 vadas, for example. By eating 6 vadas, I'm violent to my stomach. I can see ordinary light. But if I look at 1,000 candle bulb, violent to my eye. I can listen to some sound of some intensity. You start listening to very, very high sounds, violent to your ear. So you can be violent to all the 5 senses. Eating, after all, one. A fellow is vegetarian. But he goes on hurting everybody, goes on harming everybody. Worst violent fellow. So, ahimsa meaning, your words should be soothing. Speak softly. Speak sweetly. When you talk, people should feel elevated. When Baba says, Yemappa Bhaguntiva, oh boy, how are you? Yemma Bangar, Ipudacho, when did you come? Yemma, where is Manmadha? Meaning husband. He looks at the wife and says, where is Manmadha? Meaning, how about your husband? Manmadha is the most handsome fellow. So when wife says, when Swami says to the wife, where is your Manmadha? Most handsome. Ah, yes, Swami. She is very happy. In fact, he is not Manmadha at all. He knows how to make people happy. And suddenly he comes to the husband and says, how is your wife? And when I am, why should you ask about my wife? Why? When I am here, why do you ask about my wife? Why? You'll be happy. Swami is concerned for my family. Family care. Swami cares for my family, my children. Swami loves us all. This word of inquiry proves that he takes care of all of us. That is a boost. That is a boost. And supposing to correct you, supposing something, husband, something wrong with him, or something wrong with the wife, he'll go call both of them for an interview and tell husband, see, your wife is a very good lady. You would not have come to this position but for her. She's managing the whole family. She's taking care of, and this lady will be balloon, parachutes. And then give them vibhuti. As both of them try to come out of the interview, because if he leaves at that stage, the husband will get it later. Because he was praising the wife. What to do? This fellow cannot say, Swami, stop. I'll have a problem. Please praise me also for some time. We cannot say that. So when we are about to leave the interview, Swami will look at the wife. See, your husband is a very noble man. Very kind-hearted man. Because of troubles in the office, he is sometimes angry. He is very busy with files. He is going on tour. But he thinks of you only in your heart. Finish. That is peace established. And the fellows get corrected naturally. Yes. Swami's style, ahimsa, non-violence. Suddenly he'll call a student along with his parents and tells the parents, this boy, best boy in our university. Very, very well behaved. He's a singer, he's an actor. He does so much work in the hostel. You're very, very lucky to have him. Huh? Very, very nice. Parents go. He'll close the doors. All right, boy, come here. You're misbehaving. I know. I know what you are doing in the hostel. You are not attending prayers. You failed in two subjects. You are a rowdy, idiot, stupid, donkey, pig, pata, 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 he'll give. All shots, bullets. And then we'll tell him finally, I praised you in front of your parents. So that you know how to be, how not to be. These are words, how not to be. Those are words spoken to your parents, how to be. Behave properly, okay? I did not tell your parents, I love you more than them. Behave yourself. Give him a chain. What that fellow who is talkative, the moment that polish, refinement, culture, passing through the furnace, it is over like a iron that melts, steel plant, the moment he comes out. What happened to this fellow? And Swami also will tell him, don't tell anybody I scold you. And this fellow. And Swami gave interview. What did Swami say? He praised you. He won't open his mouth. Because that steel plant, this is non-violence. Not insulting grown-up children before everybody. Get things done, not by condemnation. Not by condemnation. Swami's technique. Ayayo. When this happened, boy said, Swami, sir, Kumar sir, Swami is calling for interview, you go, they said. I did not hear my name, Ra. No, sir, we heard you go. Boys love me, and I love boys. They may be of any class. I love to spend time with them, tease them. Unless I tease them and joke, my digestion will be affected for the day. So I call them, joke like that. So boys said, sir, sir, Swami come. They love me. So they must have heard my name, so I went there. Swami said, come in. I sat there. But he did not call me. Boys misheard it. So, see the Divine Master style. Good. All are here. Oh, Principal, you are also here. Good. See, Anil Kumar, Radha Krishna. Find out where he is. You go. I think, find out Radha Krishna. Radha Krishnan lived with Swami for 20 years. A very good boy. Very good boy. Swami is a shadow. Anil Kumar, call Radha Krishnan. So I came out of the interview room and went on searching for Radha Krishnan. I went to that car shed. There is one driver by name Unni. That Unni said, sir, Radha Krishnan? Okay, sir, please come. He made me sit on a chair. He offered me a glass of water. And said, sir, Radha Krishna is there with Swami only. He is there with Swami only. In order to send you out, he asked you to find out where he is not. He has not offended me. He got his work done. That is divine technology. We heard of B-Tech, M-Tech. Sat Sai Baba is a D-Tech, divine technology. Divine technology, Ahimsa. He will not hurt anybody by any gesture, by any action. See, supposing there is a table. I started speaking in divine presence of Baba from the year 1978, 3 to 4 times every year. There is a table. We do namaskar and give speech. Please observe all DVDs. Right from, he will keep his hands like that. Why? While doing Padamaskar, as you get up, your head may hit the table. So he'll keep his fingers. That is Satya Sai Baba. That is Satya Sai. That's why we love him. So these are the ethics. And then about morals, few words for want of time. Because each requires a lot of elaboration. Particularly a fellow like me who lived with him for 40 years. Naturally, I go on speaking. Things start appearing here. What am I to do? My business is only enter, enter. Next thought, enter, enter. Because all these things are saved here. No, nothing is deleted from my computer. Everything is saved. So naturally, they start appearing on the screen of my mind. Now, about morals, few points. He's has got supreme tolerance. Tolerance is a moral value. Tolerance is moral. How do you say Baba is tolerant? He is tolerating all of us. He is tolerating all of us. In fact, most of us are useless to be there. Most of us are unfit to be there. We never follow what he tells. And he will never say it out. No. Now is there any bulletin board? The following are allowed, the following are not allowed. Not like that. We have got multiple entry visa to Prashanthinilayam. Because Mahendran repeated question, I picked up certain vocabulary and a computer nomenclature. So, anybody can come, anybody. This is tolerance. So one fellow falls at his feet, Swami, I am sorry, I did so many mistakes, Swami. Swami, please excuse me. Right. Forget about it, Ra. What? Forget the past. Past is past. Be happy. Why do you say that? Past, you are my child. Don't cry. That is tolerance. Tolerance is forgiveness. That tolerance. Any number of examples can be given. In his childhood, Swami was served vadai. You know vada? And that householder invited Swami. And he went there. In that vada, she mixed poison. Vadas as it is. And people started scolding that lady. Why have you invited? Why have you mixed poison? Swami said, don't scold her. Don't scold her. And then, after some time, that lady invited him again. Baba said, normal vada is enough. Special vada. I don't need special vada. Normal vada. That is tolerance of Baba. Once when Baba was sleeping in a hut, people wanted to set that hut into fire. Yes. And some enemies brought the matchbox. Swami was talking to everybody, suddenly got up and went outside. All were wondering what happened to him. He went outside, he saw these fellows ready. Then he said, hey, the matchbox is wet, rah. Next time bring dry box. It is wet. That is tolerance. That is Satya Sai Baba. That is Satya Sai Baba, tolerance. Tolerance is moral. Forbearance is moral. Purity is moral. Cleanliness is moral. So moral, Swami, how clean is, you know that? Nails cut. Abba, you see the flesh also. Totally cut. And if he looks at my nails, he'll call me a ghost or a human being. Yeah. Very neat. And how about the dress? Pakka neat. Folded. And he won't like these exposing shorts. No. He wants you to be like that. He wants to be modest. He wants you to be latest and modest. Very important. So that's a moral value. That's a moral value. And suppose you come in, you are a doctor. You are a doctor. Why supposing you are a doctor? Wrong English, excuse me. So when doctor is talking to Swami, is this a doctor? I see. How one gets heart attack? I see. Cholesterol? Blood pressure? As if he never heard of it. Patient listening. And finally say, look here, doctor, very nice, you're a good doctor. But I think only three are responsible for a heart attack. Hurry, worry, curry, that's all. But he gave 1 hour lecture on heart disease. Meaning, patient listening is a moral value. Patient listening. He will listen to you nicely. Because he will talk to PhD boys. And what happened to your research? They'll tell you, one subject, leadership. Management boys have got that paper on leadership. One fellow got his thesis ready on leadership. World leaders, their ways of functioning. Good. But you missed one thing, Ram. What, Swami? Baba the leader, you have mentioned. Baba is the leader, Ra. They are pushers. But Swami leads, Ra. You have no brain. Swami is 7th class discontinued. But he speaks on all these subjects. Giving patient hearing to others, giving value to what others say, respecting elders. Suppose there are elderly people, once state presidents, now they are not, but Swami respects them. Elderly people, if Swami visits this house, you know what he does? He will immediately go to elders, old people. How are you, Amma? Bhavnava? Some joint pain, sir. Don't worry, I will take care of them. How are you, sir? I see BP. Be happy. No BP. He'll talk to them. And then he'll go to puja room. Ah, it is nice. And materializes some Sevalingam for you. And he knows your house more in detail than you know. He'll immediately go to the dining room. Yeah, dining room is not proper. You Brahmins are like that. What to do? Brahmins don't maintain their kitchen properly. Abba. See Swami's kitchen? Dry. No water drop. Dry. Whereas you are a swimming pool. Moral value. And then finally he says, Amma, Grahalakshmi nu. You are the wealth of this family. Yes. Grahalakshmi. Very nice, huh? Good, very complimenting others. Recognizing talents in others. Encouraging talents in others. Really marvelous, really marvelous. Therefore, time up. We have got some question and answer session later. Before I go to that question and answer session, Vijayalakshmi has got so many personal experiences. She has got so much of inner voice, which she would share with you at the time of dining or after Harati, whichever time you allot, until she is exhausted, or until you are exhausted, or until both of you are exhausted, or until Mahendran gives a bell. That is the standard. That also is there. Now, before I go to question and answer session, let us have one song in between, because we change the flight to the next Frankfurt, next halt. Yes? What must a person do in order to take away jealousy and anger from another person? From another person. He wants to take away jealousy from other person. What you can do is, you be first free from anger and jealousy. If you are first free from anger and jealousy, the other person can be naturally freed. One has to work for it. We cannot do for others. One has to know that anger is dangerous. One has, I read somewhere, the energy that is lost while one shouts, so much of energy, there is enough for supply of electricity for 24 hours. So, you know that anger is dangerous. Therefore, when you are angry, just have some glass of water, or stand in front of mirror, or loiter in the veranda in the cool breeze. It will calm down, And jealousy. In order to win jealousy, secret is this. Well, that man is very tall. I am short. I am jealous of him. Immediately think, I am fairer than him. That man is very, very rich, but I am healthier than him. He can sing, I can dance. We are all Baba's children. He gives one gift or other to everybody. If you discover your own talent, if you discover your own self, there is nobody to compete with, no one to feel jealous of. Yes, why not? So, come on, you play tabla, he plays harmonium. Where is the question of jealousy? If he also wants to play, there comes the problem. Why? Not necessary. I've got my own thing. So please discover yourself. This is what is called art of self-discovery. Art of self-discovery is the way to win over jealousy. Thank you. How do we find a way to obtain Baba's guidance all our lives? The only way is bhajans. Sing bhajans. Read his literature. Participate in service activities. Do what he likes. Supposing if you want to please your father, what should you do? Give him first hot cup of coffee without asking. 25% is favorable to you. Then keep all that shaving set there. 50% gone. Serve him breakfast. Then get the shoe and socks lace ready. Finish, you ask anything, he will give you. How to please your mother? Help her in cooking. Help her in bringing all the vessels and plates there. And tell her, cooking is very nice. Chutney is very... Don't eat like a buffalo and come out. No, no. It's nice. The curry... I really don't like those fellows who simply eat and come out. There's no difference between zoo and these fellows. Can't you say it's very nice? It's good. Can't you say that? So, say, Amma, very nice. And then he say, Amma's food is Amma's food. Why not? Done. So, when you do what your parents like, they'll guide you. Similarly, when you do what Baba likes, he'll protect you and guide you. What does he like? Service. What does he like? Sing his glory bhajans. That's all. Very easy to please Baba. Very easy. That's okay, am I clear? Right. What was your best experience with Swami? There is no question of good experience, better experience, best experience. Where they are not relative. Every experience is best unto itself. Not anything separate. Everything is best experience. Visit to Brunei is best experience. I never thought. I'm telling you, you know that? I was to leave next morning. On the previous evening at 7 o'clock, I get the passport and the visa. Impossible. I told the gentleman also, had I been there in position, I would have said, Anadhanada, Dinanada, Sayanada, Arivom, excuse me. You could do that, not me. So, don't worry. Everything is best experience. Next time, next visit, I'll give you a series of experiences. Just wait for the next visit. I notice some of them getting dream and try to push their idea in Samiti. Can you tell us little about these dreams? Dreams are individual. Supposing I dream that I'm the President of the United States of America. Tell everybody I'm President of America. They will say, you are not President of America. You are the President of Madcaps. Swami blesses me in interview. If you go on telling me, Swami bless me. He bless you. Why do you tell me? Why do you tell me? So dreams are personal. They are not general. They are not publicity. They are not for advertisement. They are not propaganda. They are not to be imposed. Swami told me that you should give me 100 rupees. Come on. Then you can tell. Swami told me not to trust you. There is one lecturer in our college. That fellow, people are afraid of him. Because he starts dreams. Everybody in the class also. So when he comes this way, people will go that way. Unfortunately, I had to face him. Already I had 2 years of experience, dreams. That day was about, Arey Babu, Swami appeared in my dream last night. Not to believe your dreams. Not to trust you. Better I avoid you also, he said, my dream. That fellow stopped speaking about dreams. So don't believe these dreamers. Don't believe these dreams. They may be true at the individual level, not at the general level. Thank you very much. Thank you. Sai Ram, Sai Ram.